Welcome back, this is John Locke, and today I want to talk about avoiding non-composited animations as a means to improving your cumulative layout shift and page speed insights. Now, you might not understand anything of what I just said, but let me back it up. Okay, in May of 2021, Google has said that they're going to start using web core vitals as a signal in SEO. If you get all of these things up here green, then it can be a boost. Okay, so this is a site called Page Speed Insights. It's on the Google's developer site, but basically you can run any URL through this. For this particular URL, I'm using my own site for an example, but I got a 72 on desktop and I got a 28 on mobile, so I need to improve a lot of things here. Some of the things that I need to improve are reducing the sizes of the images that are being delivered. On mobile, I have a cumulative layout shift to zero, but on desktop, it has a larger cumulative layout shift. We've done a few videos on this, but basically, I don't know if you can really see these screenshots, but basically, what happens is there's elements that shift when this page is being rendered. And there's a couple other things that I need to fix as well, is deferring any JavaScript. Some of these things like YouTube and Google Analytics, I really am already deferring what I can. This one thing, the facade alternative for YouTube, I gotta add a helper script to my theme to make this work, so I'll come back to that later. But one thing that I noticed when I was looking at all this, when it's talking about cumulative layout shift, was this: avoid non-composited animations, and it said there is 70 animated elements found. Okay, so I looked at this and I'm like, non-composited animations, what does this mean? All right, so basically I got educated on this. It's any element that animates, basically, that's not opacity or transform, will cause this to trigger. And I didn't really realize that this makes rendering the page a little bit slower. So I will back this up. This avoiding non-composited animations. All right, so this is the way that the browser renders a page. Now this says non-composited animations can appear janky, not smooth on low-end phones when performance heavy tasks are running on the main thread. Janky animations can increase the cumulative layout shift, which is how much it shifts, how much the layout of the page shifts from the time that you open the URL until the time that the page renders. And what they're looking for is, you know, as close to zero as possible, but I think it's like under 1.15. I think something 0.13, something like that. But it will improve your Lighthouse performance score. Page Speed Insights uses Lighthouse. Basically, it's all Google stuff. All right, so this is how the browser renders stuff. It has to get all the pixels and then render it in the page. Like when you open a web page, it has to figure out what to put where in order to make the page appear on your browser, in your browser, on your screen, okay? So the first step is a JavaScript and styling, CSS, layout, painting, and compositing. So this is rendering pipeline, okay? The key thing to understand is each step of the rendering pipeline, the browser uses the result of the previous operation to create new data. So if your code does something that triggers the layout, the paint and composite steps need to run again. So it runs again and again. A non-composited animation is any animation that triggers one of the earlier steps in the rendering pipeline. So these purple ones, the style and layout, okay, or paint in the, you know. Non-composited ones perform worse because they force the browser to do more work, right? So one thing that I didn't realize is basically composited and non-composited animations are on different layers, like in the stack in the actual screen in the browser. So there's ways to get around this. Okay, and they talk about it here on this page. Stick to compositor only properties and manage the layer count. Okay, this is something I also didn't know. Okay, so this person, Paul Lewis, says compositing is where the painted parts of the page are put together for displaying on screen. There are two factors in this area that affect page performance: the number of compositor layers that need to be managed and the properties that you use for animation. So basically, if you stick to transform, which is a CSS attribute, and opacity, then that will, you'll be in the safe. Okay, you can promote moving elements, animated elements, with the will change attribute or translate Z. Okay, avoid overusing promotion rules because these layers do require memory and management in your browser, and it can actually slow it down if you like make everything that next layer. So he goes on to say the best performing version of the pixel pipeline avoids both layout and paint and only requires compositing changes. So JavaScript, CSS, and it straight to composite. And in order to achieve this, you need to stick to changing properties that can be handled by the compositor alone. These are parts in the browser. Today, there are only two properties for which that is true: transform and opacity. So you can do transform. You can use transform to do translate, which like moves stuff around on the x-axis, the y-axis, and the z-axis, which is like out from the screen. So the x, the y, and then the z. Okay. You can do transform using scale to make things bigger or smaller. You can rotate it using transform. Skew, I can't remember what that one is off the top of my head. Matrix 3D and opacity. So that's, if you can't do it with one of these things, then it causes a delay in the compositing of the page in the browser. They say the caveat for using transforms or opacity is that the element in which you change these properties should be on its own compositor layer. So you promote the element that you cover next. So you can use this piece of CSS. If it's a moving part, anything that you plan to animate within reason, don't overdo it, to its own layer. Moving element will change transform. So this is supported in Chrome. I don't know about other browsers. Or you can do this moving element transform using translate Z. Any browsers that are going back like about 8 or 9 years probably support this. I'll have to look this up on Can I Use. All right, so it looks like it's supported pretty much in most browsers, not IE 11. These things only have like less than 1.2% of all usage. That one. As you can see, these other usages of these browsers, not very high, so you're probably pretty safe. You're going to get a lot of coverage. It says global coverage is just over 92%. So, okay, so you can use that. All right. Oh, let's look at will change. All right, so will change, it says 95%. So there you go. Again, IE 11 and below doesn't support this. Edge. The older versions don't support it, but I mean, those are like, you're talking back to 2018. So most browsers are going to support these. So that's good. All right. So this should work, and I will add this to my code base tonight and we'll find out. Okay. So it's, tempting. This guy says it's tempting to know that these layers will help performance to promote all the elements on your page with something like using the asterisk selector, which is every element. Asterisk means like every element that is in a web page will be selected with that. Okay, so will change transform and then transform translate Z 0 as a fallback. So that promotes every element in the page, which ends up using all the resources in your browser, ends up making it slower. Okay, so they go on to say here you can use Chrome DevTools to understand layers in your app. You open DevTools by right-click, how do you do that? It's right-click, and you open the DevTools, anyway, and then tick this little paint box in the timeline, and it'll show like how long certain elements take to paint. So I guess you can do this too. I'll have to check this out. Looks like it's in timeline. And then you check this little paint box right there. Okay. So, and it shows how long it takes to render each thing. So you can do this to kind of check out and troubleshoot your pages and see what's loading slow and see what you need to do. Okay, so lastly, here's this thing from Smashing Magazine. I guess this is from four years ago. I guess I'm behind the times. Anyway, it talks about this more too, using Transform Translate Z or Will Change Transform to make smooth animation, but now it's being measured in page speeds insights. These are the browser layers, the GPU layers. This top layer is the implicit compositing, separate layer, what we just talked about. And then it shows this kind of in the display. And they use the analogy, it's like how you used Zoom 1 in Internet Explorer 6. This was like going out, like when I was first learning web design, but Internet Explorer 6 is something that was still used. It's kind of a fallback. A browser hack is what they used to call it, because different browsers render things differently. And back then, 10 years ago, or even if you go further back than that, it just was more and more divergent from one another. So anyway, I guess I'm just catching up to this. But this is one thing that you can do. I'm going to try and implement this on my own site and see how it does. But let's go back to this too. Will this give you a big rankings boost? Like I said, Google said that you have to get all this stuff in the green to get a rankings boost. So, and I don't expect the rankings boost to be like big. You're going to still have to have the right content on the page. But let's look at these other things. First, contentful paint. Again, that's the biggest element that's in the screen when you first open the browser. So usually that's going to be some headline. In this case, it's like a hero image. So how long does that take to render? I need to go back and decrease the size maybe of some of my images. This one's in the green, but there's other pages where it's not like this. Speed index, that's an overall assessment. Largest contentful paint, or first contentful paint right here is like how, I'm misspoke here. This is how fast the page begins to be painted. And again, we talked about this, the paint. Okay. But the largest contentful paint is the biggest element. Time to interactive is when you can actually interact with the page. Total blocking time is that is any scripts or any files or CSS or anything else that needs to be loaded before the page can begin to render. So anything that's blocking that, and we'll look at that again. Reducing the initial server time on me. I don't know why this is 860 milliseconds. Not really sure. But you can see here there's JavaScript from YouTube. That's transfer size and potential savings. Using a validation for my email signup. Also like JavaScript here for YouTube. Google Tag Manager, jQuery, and again, this is GTag, that's Google Analytics. So I could save a little fraction of a second by making this smaller. I am using a WebP for that with a JPEG for a fallback. Ensuring text remains visible during web font load. This is font awesome. I do have this loading inline right now, so it's 110 milliseconds. It's not a ton. Okay, third-party code. This is mostly going to be like Google properties because there's YouTube, Amazon Web Services. That's the MailChimp validation. Google Tag Manager, Google Analytics, Google Fonts, Gravatar is on my blog post. Is not on the rest of it, but the only one that's like really blocking is this YouTube. Yeah, just the YouTube ones. That's it, because this is like the blocking time. And again, this is another thing I need to implement with the facade alternative available. I just found out about this too, so this is something that I need to look into and experiment with my own site. Then maybe I can roll it out to some of my client sites. And then image elements don't have an explicit height and width. This is on my logo and then on my DMCA badge. So maybe I'll add one there if I can. And then static assets with an efficient cache policy. I'm going to bet that these are the Google Analytics. So we got Gravatar. These are all Google Analytics. Double click. Google Analytics. Again, that MailChimp one, the DMCA. That's it. And then these are all ones that aren't marked as anything. So I'm going to try this out. I'm going to see what happens. Let's look at the mobile really quick. Cumulative layout shift on this is 0. I did move to system fonts on my site. I am using system fonts, which means that I'm not loading any external fonts. I'm using a font stack that basically says, like, use this font first, and then if that one isn't present, go to the next one. But it's set up basically to use the fonts that are available on Windows, Mac, iPhone, Android machines, and then one of those fonts will like hit before it gets to sans serif or serif fonts in the font stack. So this one, again, largest contentful paint, I need to decrease the image size right there. Time to interactive, it's more blocking time. I'm not sure why that is. There is CSS, it didn't need to be used. It's a cached version of my CSS plus YouTube. Properly sized images, I can save some time. Text compression, that is on, that's weird. That's on that MailChimp deal. Got server time, it's same one. But deferring this blocking resource jQuery. I did this, I actually implemented this. And what happened is, because I use Gravity Forms for my contact forms, when I deferred jQuery, the contact forms no longer worked. So I couldn't defer this. I have to load this before I load Gravity Forms on the pages or it doesn't work. So compromise. Again, you know, the speed, it'll help a little bit if everything else on your page is right. It's just one of those things that Google is trying to encourage, and other people will look this up as well, and other people might ask about this. A lot of people probably aren't even aware of this stuff. A lot of webmasters, a lot of people who own websites, probably not even aware of this stuff. So I can't imagine that they would weight it like completely all that heavy, but it's a lot of the same things here. So anyway, I hope that you learned something about non-composited and composited animations, because I sure did. And I'm going to be implementing this on my site and probably in future sites that I build for other people as well. My name is John Locke. This is my business, Lockedown Design and SEO. This is my YouTube channel, and I'm here on a regular basis. Putting out videos, and I would appreciate a subscription and a thumb up on this video if you learned something. If you have a question, leave it in the comments of any of these videos. I will be sure to answer. And until next time, peace.